All right, so the first question is, where can I practice system design in the real world? Let's see what the bot has to tell us. This is actually a pretty good answer. System design, especially if you're trying to do this yourself, requires you to have some sort of experience in building systems. Side projects, yes. So that's been mentioned in point number two, work on personal projects. You can do things that interest you and then look at the opportunities to actually optimize that system. Another thing that I talk about a lot is contributing to open source projects. You can work on projects which have real business use cases, real world contributors, and it's a project which has an impact in the real world. One of the drawbacks here, obviously, is that you can't just go in and make whatever changes you want in the system. Unlike in a hackathon, which is your personal project, this open source project has some rules, some regulations, and it's a good learning experience because as your team scales, these practices help in contributing even to work projects. Join a study group or meetup. This is interesting. I have never really thought of this where multiple people sit down and study system design. I always think in terms of colleagues who pick up some reference projects in the company and then you discuss about its architecture. So you could call that a study group, but really it's more like team discussions and just design reviews. So those help a lot more, I think, than a study group or a meetup. Meetups have a lot of unnecessary conversations going on, unnecessarily like, hi, I'm Gaurav Sen, you know, I work on this, and the other person says, hi, I work on this, and a few questions here and there might help you get some understanding of system design, but this point I would probably disagree with, or at least partially agree with. Study group is possibly useful. The hackathon idea, I didn't even think of this earlier. You have a system that you develop from scratch, that's the benefit, and then if you really like that system, you can, you know, on the side, you can work with them in that project. The problem with any kind of online hackathon is you have a lot of boilerplate code and a lot of stuff that is already out there, which you have to build yourself again. You might think about external libraries which do this for you. You might think of platforms which do this for you. But always, in my experience, whenever there's a hackathon, a lot of it is, I need to set up this database. I need to actually talk to this system in Firebase, which is already taken care of in many projects. Even if you copy the code, it takes time to actually set it up. It's a bit of a waste of a time. But you meet new people, so there's that benefit. All in all, the idea of online hackathon is pretty interesting if you don't have any friends at office who are also interested in system design. Okay, work on real world problems. A lot of this looks like what they have in point number two and point number three, even point number one. So this point I would say is just a repetition, just useless, you know. So now it's time for a rating. Out of five, how much should we rate this answer? I would give this answer something like a strong three out of five, because it's good enough, it's useful. The best two points in this are contributing to open source projects and working on your personal projects. Okay, the online hackathon bit, meetups, a lot of socializing, I find it okay, useful, not so useful. Maybe a 0.5 over there, so a strong 3 or 3.5. But working on real world problems and, you know, meetups seems to be a little bit of a repetition here. Instead, you can focus on what you're currently doing at work. That could be really useful. And instead of study groups, if you have some sort of design reviews or discussions during sprint planning, if you bring this kind of stuff up, it will really help your team. And I think they'll be very, very appreciative of what you're doing. So more on the professional work side and a little lesser on the social side. All right, thank you for listening. Do let me know your thoughts and comments. How do you rate this answer by an AI bot on how to learn or practice system design in the real world? I'm interested in listening to your comments because I think my experience as a software engineer is unidimensional, and your answers are going to add a lot of interesting perspectives to this. See you.